Hello everyone, and welcome to the USBG Weekly. I am Aaron Gregory Smith, Executive Director of the Guild. Today is August 18th. And thank you for joining me. So today, you know, preservation is always about time. It's about racing against time and really embracing time. For centuries, we've had lots of different methods of preservation, whether that's drying things out, using temperature, and as science has continued to evolve, we've learned about other ways of preserving our food and other things that might spoil. Today we're going to be talking about methods of preserving wine, along with other approaches to keeping those pour costs low when you're developing a wine program. My guest today is Gary Gottfried. Gary has served as the chair of the Preparedness Industries Working Group for Specialty Food Association, and is a longtime member and educator for the Society of Wine Educators. So I want to welcome Gary on. Gary is also going to be with us at one of our regional conferences coming up, where he'll be presenting on this topic of preserving wine and making sure that our beverage programs are thoughtful about how we serve this product. Gary, welcome so much. Thanks for being here.
Hey, thanks, Aaron. Thanks for having me on board. It's great.
Absolutely. So, you know, we've all had wine maybe, quote unquote, go bad on us. Whether now that's the bottle that we just didn't finish after dinner, or the bottle we opened earlier this week so a guest could try it. And it just didn't get served all the way through. So many of us may have heard that wine oxidizes, but what exactly does that mean?
Yeah, well, first of all, wine doesn't actually go bad in the sense it's health issue or whatever, but it does taste different. It tastes funny. It doesn't taste like you originally opened up the bottle, you know, after it's been sitting around. And that basically all of a sudden, geez, you know, you drink it the next day, it's kind of like, what happened, you know? So oxidation is actually the process that affects wine, along with two other areas. And it ends up being temperature, as well as between that and having the oxygen situation, and then UV light, I mean sunlight. So anyhow, oxidation itself is really an important element to understand. Oxidation is due to oxygen. So oxygen basically affects wine, but it also probably is recognizable, like what happens when you bite into an apple, you know, 5 minutes later, you're looking at this apple and it's like turning brown. It's like, what's happening? Well, that's an example of oxidation, as well as a really more severe piece, like iron turning to rust. So,
right. Or copper getting that film on it, right?
Oh, yeah. How many pennies have we had that have sitting there with this little green tint to it? It's like, where did that come from?
Yeah, the Statue of Liberty. awesome. So, you know, what is it, as we talk about preserving our food items or preserving our beverages, wine is especially open to oxidation. And tell us a little bit about why oxidation happens to wine, maybe in a way that we don't have to worry about so much with other types of spirit, like other types of our consumables, like spirits.
Yeah, well, you know, it's interesting when you bring that up, because there's like different degrees, particularly, you know, something that people will learn from the presentation. Hopefully they're going to be there in Columbus to go ahead and hear it. But I think that basically, you know, there's different wines oxidize at different rates. There's different aspects about it. There's a lot of science to this. And it's one of those things I think is important for everybody to know. Science rules. I think it basically, you know, takes a lot of the voodoo out of things. So,
right.
You know, so hopefully it's recognized that different, you know, different products will go and oxidize at different rates. I mean, people can look at, you know, olive oils. Olive oils oxidize.
Right.
Okay. You know, which is totally another product that's faces the whole thing with the UV light and the temperature.
Oh, 100%. 100%. So as bar operators, as people involved in operations there, what should we do about this, you know, the physical science fact that some of our things are going to oxidize? What should we do?
Yeah, well, you know, that first of all, come to the presentation. Come to the conference. That's number one.
Science,
more people, by the way, you know, what you ought to know is get an opportunity to learn the facts or to go ahead and ask the questions. And I think what I find more often than not is anybody that goes ahead and hears a story, the questions come up, but then when they can be explained or rationalized in a favorable way, all of a sudden they think differently. And I go, oh, that makes sense. And none of us like to go into, answering questions from customers, patrons, or anything without knowing the answers. And the idea is to go and have the answers in hand. So there are different forms of means to be able to go ahead and preserve. Hope to be able to cover, we'll cover all of them during the presentation, but basically there's, five major categories. So I think it's the type of thing where people hear each of them, they can think about the pros, the cons, and what's good for them, particularly with their operations and themselves.
Oh, excellent. Excellent. And between these five different methods, if you had to pick one that would be a good takeaway for somebody watching right now, what might that be?
Yeah, well, the best takeaway, I'm not going to divulge everything, but I will say this. This is really important. People will understand this. This isn't necessarily the most effective, but it's probably the easiest, and it's very simple, and that is refrigeration. Simply the fact, refrigeration, why do we put things in the fridge? Well, because it lowers the temperature. Temperature, actually, by lowering it, slows down oxidation. It doesn't stop it, but it slows it down. So by doing that, it gives everybody the opportunity to be able to go ahead and buy a little time. That's why, actually, why most people, when they put their whites in the fridge, it seems like, hey, my whites are fine. My reds sitting on the counter. God, why are they going bad? So they're worried. But I will tell you one little tip here is if you had a red bottle of wine and a white bottle of wine sitting on the counter, the white is going to go first.
Oh,
Because it's not refrigerated then. And there's some other reasons behind that. So
science.
Well,
Gary, thank you so much for putting this presentation together, for joining us today to talk about the conference in Columbus, where we're going to be learning a little bit more about wine preservation and all those different methods. Preserving your pour cost is a really important part of the bar operation, and that wine category has a really important customer that we want to reach out to and take special care with that preservation. So I'm looking forward to seeing you in Columbus and learning more from your presentation.
Same, thanks. And just for everybody else, one other thing, one of the big things that we talk about is how it actually helps you make more revenue. So that's a really
perfect
big thing from top to bottom, whether you're an owner, the general manager, a frontline professional like you, most of your people are, they need to be able to be familiar and understand because it's going to affect their pocketbook.
Absolutely. And what a great motivator and something that is really important for all of us to remember where, the hospitality business is a business. And whether you're earning a wage or earning a bonus or earning a profit share, profitability is really important. Gary, absolutely. Thank you so much. For those of you watching and joining us today, regional conferences are coming up in October. Houston at the beginning of the month, Columbus at the end of the month, which is where we'll see Gary. You can register now at usvg.org. Tomorrow, Haven Mastenbrook, one of our financial and insurance gurus, is going to be joining Naomi Ayala at USBG NCF. That's at the USBG Foundation Weekly. Same time tomorrow, noon Pacific, 3 p.m. Eastern. So come learn about what kinds of insurance you need to stay safe. Gary, thank you again, and we'll talk to you soon.
Thanks, Aaron.
All right, bye, y'all.
Bye.